So guys, the Ellis brothers, bro, I'm telling you, these guys is something serious. To be honest, my fault, bro. My fault that I'm just now tapping in with these Ellis brothers, bro. These guys are tough. In this video, I'm sure you guys have heard by now, this man, Mikey Williams in Vertical Academy, just got outplayed by an eighth grader. I don't know how old eighth graders are, bro. I don't think, or what are they, 18, 13? I think they're 13, 14, whatever. They got outplayed by an eighth grader and a ninth grader, bro. Shout out to them. Guys, shout out to the Ellis brothers, but man. Guys, quick question for every single one of you guys watching this video. How good do you guys actually feel like the Ellis brothers are gonna be in the future? Because man, as an eighth grader, as a ninth grader, these guys just went crazy. These guys went bananas on Mikey Williams and Vertical Academy, bro. This was definitely something to watch. Like I said, guys, in this video, we're gonna be breaking down the Ellis brothers. Who exactly are these guys? What did they do this past weekend? Everything along those lines. So make sure you guys stick around, watch the full video, subscribe to the channel, leave a like, guys. It helps the channel out in so many ways. You guys have no idea. Make sure you guys are actually following me on Instagram at JuiceManHoops with the extra S at the end. Probably pop it up on the screen here. And yeah, with all that being said, guys, we're not gonna waste any more time. I love every single one of you guys watching this video. Let's go and get straight into this video. So guys, boom, let's go and get straight into this video and talk about this crazy weekend regarding this man Mikey Williams and two up-and-coming players in that 2025 high school class and the 2026 high school class. Now, since Vertical Academy plays a national schedule, their season actually starts a little bit earlier than most, and Mikey and the squad had a season opener against Moravian Prep in North Carolina. Now, Moravian, they are a legit team. They were a top four team in the state a year ago, so I'm telling you, this was actually a legit matchup for Vertical Academy. Now, Moravian has two guys in particular that were really buckets, and they can do some crazy things out there on the floor. One is named Eli Ellis, who is only a freshman in that 2025 high school class, and then his younger brother, Isaac Ellis, who's in that 2026 high school class, who, like I said, is only in the eighth grade. Now guys, what if I told you that an eighth grader, like I said, I don't know how old they are, like 14, 13, 15, I don't know, guys. What if I told you an eighth grader just dropped 30 points on Vertical Academy and was shooting the lights out and just blew Vertical Academy out the water, guys? I'm telling you, I know a lot of people would not believe me, and the crazy part is that these aren't your out the blue freshmen and eighth graders at 6'6 that be getting fed 8 Big Macs a day, bro, that looks like they're 26, 25. These are your regular old kids just like you and me who can simply hoop and knows how to put the bucket in the hole, guys. These guys was on fire, and we really need to pay respect where respect is due. And I'm telling y'all, Mr. Eli and Isaac Ellis, they're both a dynamic duo that's gonna be something serious in the future. Now guys, who are these two players in particular? Eli, like I said, he's in that 2025 high school class, and he's listed as a 5'11 point guard. And Eli, to me, he's a legit point guard who can definitely do a ton of great things on the floor, who can shoot the ball, whether it's off the dribble, the catch, screens. This guy can shoot the lights out, and he can also create for his teammates as well. He will throw those slick passes, those no-look passes that defenders just aren't expecting, and his play style is a big factor to why he already has a couple Division I offers being only a freshman. Just like I said on Instagram, Eli is not going to come across as a hooper or somebody who will dazzle you with his play style, but you can always count on Eli doing the little things right, staying patient, just simply being a good basketball player. Like I said, there is a reason why he has a couple Division I offers, and as the years progress, it's only gonna keep adding and adding and adding and adding, and he plays great competition, so I'm telling you, he's been doing this thing for a couple years now. Guys, for those who don't know, he was playing varsity a year ago while only being in the eighth grade, so nobody can sit here and tell me that he's not good, because everybody and their mama, like I said, are saying that Mikey Williams, Trey Parker, they are one of the top duos in the entire country. In Vertical Academy, they got outplayed by an eighth grader and a ninth grader. Guys, it's just facts whether people want to hear it or not. Trey had 28, Mikey had 21. We're not gonna act like they didn't show up. We're not gonna act like they didn't put on show, but they just did not perform enough to get the win. I'm telling y'all, the Ellis brothers, they are legit. They deserve the respect, and they're gonna get their respect from me on this channel. And then real quick, with his brother Isaac Ellis, like I said, he's only in the eighth grade, who's in that 2026 high school class. And I'm telling y'all, this guy can shoot the lights out. This man Isaac, he's hit 12 threes in a game. which is insane, and there's not a lot of guys that can actually do that in an actual game. I love the confidence and the dog mentality that he plays with, and if you watch the game, you can clearly see that he wanted to smoke with Mikey Williams and Vertical Academy, and he was on their head, and he loves the attention. I respect him even more just because he was backing everything that he was talking about on the court. He led all scores with 30 points for the night, and like I said, this man is only in the 8th grade, guys. I know I keep saying that, I've been saying it multiple times, bro. But I don't think they heard me in the back. Shout out to both Eli and Isaac Ellis. Like I said, they deserve the Medal of Honor today. They both put on a great show. And I can't wait to watch both of these players in the next coming years. But guys, that's just my personal opinion. Like I said, this was a great weekend, great game with every player that was involved. I'm telling you guys, these two players in particular, they're going to be something special in the next coming years. If these guys end up being 6'5", 6'6", we're going to see another Tyler Hero being born, bro. This is honestly insane. Shout out to both Eli and Isaac, like I said. Shout out to Mikey Williams as well as Trayvon Parker and Vertical Academy. Like I said, they also put on a show, so we're not going to act like they didn't do that. But we got to give respect where respect is due. These guys are underclassmen, and they put on a show. They won the game. They beat a top team in the country, so we got to give the respect where respect is due. That's just my personal opinion. What do you guys think? Just comment down below. Let's get a great basketball conversation started, guys. If you made it to the end, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. If you made it to the end, please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, guys. It helps the channel out in so many ways. Please follow me on Instagram at JuiceMateHoops with the extra S at the end. And once again, guys, thank you for watching. It's been another episode of JuiceMate TV. So guys, the centers, they need some love too. Top five centers in this 2023 high school class. At number five, I have to go with this man, Brandon Garrison. Great energy guy who simply understands what the heck it means to be a center. He's not gonna do anything extra out of his role. Super underrated. I love this man, Garrison, at number five. Number four, I have to go with this man, Cameron Barnes, from out there in Duncanville, Texas. Just based on the eye test alone, you see the potential that this man possesses. I don't know the exact wingspan that this kid has, but it's gotta be at least 18. To mandatory top five. Number three, I have this man, Jazz Gardner from California, averaging 25 and 10 for his sophomore year. I think it's a no-brainer that he's a top five center. Guys, number two, I have to go with this man, Aaron Bradshaw from Camden. He looks to be a very raw prospect being the size that he is. I think number two is pretty solid for this man, Aaron. And guys, finally, one, gotta go with this man, Bayfall, as the number one center in the class. This man, Bayfall, he is a go-getter on the floor, stretch big with the qualities, especially on the defensive end. This man, Bay, is gonna be something serious in the future.